Good afternoon, everyone. Thank you for joining us today. Today's talent show, hosted by FLO, Lucknow Kanpur chapter, has been put up by the students of NAVSRIJAN, an educational initiative by Mrs. Anjali Jaipuria. FLO is the women wing of FICCI, the Federation of Indian Chambers of Commerce and Industry. The organization conducts various activities for the upliftment of women through education and training. Education is a means to an end. By providing education to the unserved, one helps them break the vicious circle of poverty. The aim of today's program is to give you all a glimpse of what the empowering effect of education and its ability to enable children to develop a critical questioning attitude towards society, government, and the existing gender and cultural stereotypes. I would like to now invite Archana Khetanji to come and address you all.
Dear Anjali, Asha ji, teachers, dear children, guests, and my dear, dear members, I welcome all of you with the bottom of my heart, and I'm so happy that the NAVSRIJAN children are here exhibiting their hidden talents. Anjali, I'm so happy that you proposed this program and I got a chance to make my Kanpur audience have a glimpse of this unlimited talent. Anjali, you have created an opportunity for these children to get superb education and avenues for displaying their talents. I think this precedent is exemplary and should be followed by all the schools with the same zeal. Asha ji, your dedication is awesome. And I hope you continue to be a part of NAVSRIJAN always. Dear children, you all have a great platform in NAVSRIJAN and to prove your genius. So you should come forward and show to the world your innumerable talents so that every student can draw an inspiration from you. I need to make two announcements related to FLO. We have displayed some rakhis made by our village girls. You can place orders for the same. Secondly, on World Yoga Day, that is 21st of June, our Honorable PM is coming to Lucknow. So 50 members of FLO can register, but already 47 have registered. So if anybody from Kanpur is interested, please give me the names right away. And now over to the NAVSRIJAN children. Please give them a big hand.
Good afternoon, everyone. We are delighted to offer a very warm welcome to one and all present here, to the fun-filled, entertaining program presented by the students of NAVSRIJAN.
Ladies and gentlemen, the captain has turned on the fasten seatbelt sign. Please take your seats and fasten your seatbelts. My name is Ragini Bansal, and on behalf of NAVSRIJAN Airways, welcome aboard. Our flight time will be 1 hour, and we will be flying at an altitude of entertainment. During these enthralling performances, make sure your seat bags are in full upright position. Also, your electronic devices must be set to airplane mode. We should now start our program. Following our custom and tradition, I take this opportunity to invite Anjali ma'am, Asha ma'am, Anuradha ma'am, and Archana ma'am to light the lamp of knowledge. With this lamp lightning, we like to thank the goddess of knowledge for blessing us.
इस मंत्र में आत्मा को अग्नि की उपाधि दी है वह अग्नि जो ऊपर की ओर प्रज्वलित है यहाँ ऋषि का यह अभिप्राय है कि अपने विचार अपने भाव व अपने कर्म समिधा की भांति अपने भीतर स्थित अग्नि रूपी आत्मा में आहुति चढ़ाने से और उन्हें मार्गदर्शन के लिए आह्वान से मनुष्य अपने आत्मरूपी ईश्वर से संबंध स्थापित कर उन्हें अपना मार्गदर्शक पुरोहित बना सकता है थैंक यू ऑल गुड डे एवरीवन NAVSRIJAN माय स्कूल माय सेकेंड होम अ प्लेस विच गिव्स मी एनर्जी स्ट्रेंथ एंड हैप्पीनेस एज आई कम टू स्कूल आफ्टर वर्किंग इन 3 houses एज अ हाउस होल्ड हेल्पर And today, I would like to share my experience of how NAVSRIJAN has changed my life. I remember waking up every morning to the sound of aarti from nearby temple, followed by some shlokas. These shlokas always made me feel peaceful and happy. I felt as if this is eternal love of God, which is trying to be conveyed to me, but I was not able to understand the language of God's love. After joining NAVSRIJAN, I not only learned the Sanskrit shlokas, but also started understanding their beautiful meanings. I proudly stand here and say that today my family wakes up to my sounds of chanting these shlokas. Thank you.
The prayer to hold on from worldly affairs and connect myself with the Almighty.
Prayer does not change God, but it changes Him who prays. Let's captivate and begin by invoking the blessings of God.
I would like to call our principal, Mrs. Asa ma'am. Please come on the stage and present the school report.
Good afternoon, everybody. I would like to take this opportunity to applaud FICCI FLO Lucknow Kanpur team member and Mrs. Ashna Khaitan ma'am, the true change maker amongst all of us. Ashna ji has been a woman of grit that continues to inspire all of us to extend ourselves and dedicate our life to service. Under her able mentorship, FICCI FLO Lucknow Kanpur chapter has adopted 2 villages with an aim to empower women at the great grassroots level to make them both financially and emotionally independent. There can be no keener revelation of a society's soul than the way it treats its children. Unfortunately, a section of children of a society are bereft of the opportunity which the privileged avail of. Seeing this unequal balance of education in our society, Anjali ma'am incubated an English medium school, NAVSRIJAN, for the underserved children of our society who were deprived of basic right of education. The school envisions bridging the social and economic gap in society through education. With this vision, NAVSRIJAN became a reality in October 2010. When we began our school in October 2010, we had a very little inkling that it will go such a long way. Now, we have 300 underserved children in NAVSRIJAN from kindergarten to grade 7th. And hundreds of children, thousands of children are waiting outside the gate to get an opportunity in our school. The gender ratio in our school is 110 girls to 100 boys. In our humble ways, we take care of all their needs, be it uniforms, books, and much more. To ensure the need and poverty level, we visit their homes before taking them into NAVSRIJAN. No compromises are made in the selection of the faculty. We have a principal and 14 teachers in NAVSRIJAN. 11 are class teachers, 1 is a Hindi teacher, and we have 2 assistant teachers also in NAVSRIJAN. Even 3 helper IRs are dedicated to our children. We give them the same treatment as we give to the privileged children in our mainstream school. We impact them not only by English, Maths, EVS, Social Studies, and Science, but also with Sanskrit, Computer Science, Fine Arts, and Performing Arts, and Yoga also, which are taught by the expert faculty of Jaipuria School. Along with English and Hindi, we have Sanskrit as a third language in NAVSRIJAN. And I think NAVSRIJAN is the only underserved school which teaches Sanskrit from LKG onwards. The school has evolved to meet the changing needs of education. We have introduced home skills, vocational program in computer application, spoken English, and classical dance classes in the last session. As technology became more embedded in our daily lives, we have brought technology to our classrooms. Our teachers teach children through digital boards, like we had Educom smart boards and IRIS boards in our school. Along with the mainstream teachers, even NAVSRIJAN teachers are teaching through those boards. We have MindSpark, a computer-based self-learning program which deals with the mathematical and logical skills. This is educational initiatives program. And we have kept computer as a compulsory subject from class 1 onwards. Our children share the same platform with mainstream children on Founders Day, annual craft exhibition, annual athletic meet, and class forums. NAVSRIJAN children share the same infrastructure and facilities of St. M.R. Jaipuria School. They share the same classrooms, same digital boards, they have computer laboratory, they have library, and extensive playground to play. We believe in inclusive education and have metamorphosed 38 of our NAVSRIJAN children into the mainstream through a proper entrance test. And you'll be surprised to know that our NAVSRIJAN children do much better in Jaipuria mainstream entrance test, where children from all other esteemed institutions are there. In fact, all top 10 positions were always taken by our NAVSRIJAN children. Not only that, we literate them, but we give them education. Actually, I've learned the difference between the literacy and education by no other person than our founder, Anjali ma'am. And she's going to speak about the difference between literacy and education to all of you. So please wait for that treat. Okay, now I would like to again thank Archana Khaitan ma'am for giving us opportunity to reach you all. Thank you.
Lord Krishna addresses Arjun and says, "Oh Arjun, son of Kunti, whatever you do, eat, give, worship and practice, offer all of that to me. This feeling of absolute devotion is the essence of the Gita." He tells Arjun that the even smallest of the tasks can be offered to him. For us, he is our own soul. By doing so, we come in contact with him and experience him.
I don't know why history is taught in school. It is only war and revolt. Why do we use our strength and power to suppress or kill innocents?
Very true. Even I used to think like that. But my teacher has changed my mind.
Change your mind? But how?
History is not about the war. We learn from our mistakes of our forefather. There is a message with the after effect of each war and revolt. It tells us the consequences of being aggressive and then leave the choice with us. Which path should we choose?
But how?
Okay, let me show you this through a tableau and a soka.
Amidst the tens of thousands of names of monarchs that crowds the columns of history, the name of Ashoka shines and shines almost alone a star. Well said by S.G. Wells. King Ashoka, the third monarch of Indian Mauryan dynasty, was an exemplary ruler who ruled over almost all of the Indian subcontinent. From 268 to 232 BC, he was one of the greatest rulers who ruled over a realm that stretched from Hindu Kush, the mountains of Afghanistan, to the state of Bangladesh in the east. The capital of the empire was Pataliputra. Let's have a glimpse of Ashoka's life.
Ashoka was born in a royal family. He inherited the qualities of a ruler since childhood. These were apparent at an early age. He excelled his brother in the art of war and was excellent at hunting. These were evident from his ability to kill a lion with only a wooden rod. He was a fearsome hunter and the most courageous among his 100 brothers.
Divided into many small kingdoms, Ashoka wanted to fulfill the dreams of his father and grandfather, Chandragupta Maurya, to unite all the small kingdoms into one huge united India and rule over the Indian subcontinent. Ambitious, Ashoka tried to unite all the small kingdoms, but he chose the path of war.
Thank you.
kingdoms and trying to merge them to make one empire. Ashoka raised a war against many kingdoms. He conquered them one by one. But the kingdom of Kalinga was left unconquered. He sent a message to the ruler to surrender. But the king of Kalinga refused and a war broke between the two rulers.
Ashoka and his army fought a severe fight with the army of Kalinga. The entire town of Kalinga turned into a battleground. Ashoka won the great battle of Kalinga. Ashoka became victorious, but he was shocked to see where his ambition brought him. He was the biggest conqueror now, but at what cost?
Ashoka saw the bloodfield, battlefield, with his own eyes. There were orphan children crying, wounded people rolling on the ground in pain. Countless people suffered. When Ashoka saw this bloodshed, his heart was broken with shame and grief. He felt unhappy over the victory. What a dreadful deed have I done? I am the reason behind all these killings, behind these orphaned children, behind these widow women. He realized that any kind of war can continue to affect the minds and the lives of the survivors for a long time. He vowed never to fight again. He would never again commit such a crime against humanity. Kalinga War became his last war.
He searched for peace everywhere, which he found in Buddhism. He devoted the rest of his life to non-violence, ahimsa.
Buddham saranam gacchami, dhammam saranam gacchami.
But how many kings have been moved by pity in the hour of victory and laid down arms? Perhaps there has been only one such king in the history of the whole world, Ashoka the Great.
Yadyada charati sestha tatta deve taro janaha sayat pramanam kurute lokas tadanuvartate.
An ideal person inspires other people to act like him. Ordinary people follow the principles which an ideal person lives by. Gita says, an ideal person is the one who offers his existence to God and whose thoughts, feelings, and actions are spiritual. His being has the strength like none other. What we presume to be ideal by the worldly parameter is different than what the Gita says.
Lyrics become more enjoyable when we blend it with music. It becomes more meaningful when we blend it with good thoughts. So please welcome our budding singers who will entertain you with the song, The Best Days of My Life.
Hey ho!
Oh,
to share my experience of how NAVSRIJAN has fulfilled my dream of attaining education. I have faint memories of reciting A for apple and B for ball under a tree. But the memory of children walking to school in uniforms, carrying school bags and smiling faces is clear and fresh. I used to question myself, why are they going to the school and why are we studying here in a scorching heat? I was thrown out of the school due to non-payment of fees. Even I dream of studying in a good school, so I never gave up. I kept looking around and finally found about NAVSRIJAN, a school which provides education for free. After working as a domestic helper in a house, I entered this world of happiness, my school, NAVSRIJAN. I am here from the last 7 years. I have learned so much here and I feel proud to be a part of NAVSRIJAN. Thank you.
Fairy tales are more than true, not because they tell us that dragons exist, but because they tell us that dragons can be beaten.
Fairy tales take back even elders to their childhood, where the world was colorful, peaceful, and no harm could come to anybody. Okay, which is your favorite fairy tale, Radha?
I like Snow White.
Oh, what is so special in Snow White? Too kiddish, I like Little Red Riding Hood.
Oh, what is so nice about Little Red Riding Hood?
Why are you arguing? Let us call our narrator friend who will tell us the story of Little Red Riding Hood and then you can decide.
Okay.
Ladies and gentlemen, today I am going to tell you the story of Little Red Riding Hood. Once upon a time, there was a little girl.
Please somebody help me.
Who are you? What are you doing here?
My stepmother is evil. She wants to get rid of me.
Wait, little girl. Don't you see that I am the narrator and I'm telling the story of Little Red Riding Hood. Look at all those people. Oh my, I am ruined. I am going to get fired.
Please forgive me. I am a nice girl, but my stepmother doesn't love me.
Listen, we feel sorry for you, but you came to the wrong story.
Oh, really?
Yes, I have to continue with my story. Do you see that little house?
Yes.
Then go there, so you can escape from your stepmother. I'm sure they will help you.
Oh, thank you.
Following the yellow brick road.
Hey, wait! Don't you see that it's not your time to appear on scene? Leave and wait for your turn.
Okay.
Okay. Where was I? Oh, yes. Little Red Riding Hood was...
I'm so strong! I'm invincible!
Oh, no! Not again! What do you want? Who are you?
I'm Spider-Man! I know that someone here needs me!
We don't need you! Not right now! Can you please leave? Because I am working!
Sorry, ma'am.
Well, as I was telling you, Little Red Riding Hood was very nice girl. She was going to take some bread and honey for her grandmother, who lived in the woods. When suddenly, the wolf appears.
Ahoo! Oh.
Why?
I am looking for Cinderella. We were dancing, but suddenly she left and lost her shoe. Oh, you are so beautiful.
Stop it. Everybody quiet. I'm trying here to tell the story of this little girl.
That's true.
And I really don't know what you all are doing here, but I don't care anymore. So, since you won't let me tell the true story of Little Red Riding Hood, then I'll make up my own story.
See what you all did. I was the main character of the story.
Well, not anymore. Ha ha ha.
Prince Charming from Cinderella's story saw how beautiful Snow White was. He threw away the shoe and decided to marry her and have a big wedding celebration. They invited Little Red Riding Hood, the wolf, three little pigs. Okay, you also. And they lived happily ever after.
That was so hilarious. The energy you put into playing was lot of fun to watch.
Abhivadan Srilasya Nityam Vrato Pasevina Chatvaritasya Vardante Ayurvedya Yashobalam.
जो कोई भी अपने से बड़ों को प्रणाम करता है, उनकी सेवा करता है, उसकी चार चीजें बढ़ती हैं, आयुर्विद्या, यश और बल।
I take the privilege to request our honorable founder, navigator of this flagship, to speak a few words.
Anjali ma'am needs no introduction. NAVSRIJAN is her vision. Without her guidance, we would have never touched the rainbows in the sky. It is her vision and love towards us to give us the essence to obtain quality education.
It's such a pleasure to be back in Kanpur and to speak to Kanpurites. And I really don't know where to begin from. Thank you so much, Archana Jiji. Thank you so much, Flo, for giving NAVSRIJAN a chance to display their talents, to show what we are doing. I really don't need to speak about NAVSRIJAN because our beautiful, compassionate principal Asha ma'am has already spoken about it. It's just that in 2010, there's a little news clipping that I was reading, and it said that one out of every six children is uneducated in Lucknow. It was very painful to read, and I was wondering, what's everybody doing? I mean, then I realized, what's everybody doing? What am I doing? You know, and that's how the journey began, and the rest is history. We have 291 children at present. Every year we grow one class. We started with LKG, and then the next year upper KG, and one and two, and this year class seven. And it's been a beautiful journey. I can tell you that our teachers are probably the best teachers of the world. And I am not saying it because they're hearing me. I'm saying it because I mean it from my heart. Their dedication to NAVSRIJAN is absolutely unparalleled. And I think that's because their head, Asha ma'am, is so beautiful. So today, Asha ma'am has said that I should talk about the difference between literacy and education, right? Many of us sometimes believe that, well, I've given literacy to my child, so they say my child is educated. But is it really so? Let me quote somebody who I quote very often, and that's Osama bin Laden. He was literate. He was literate. He's probably studied, I don't remember, I should look up my facts before I come on the dais, but I believe he had studied in Oxford or Cambridge. So was he literate or was he educated? He was literate. Because education is education when we've educated the heart, when we've educated the senses, when we have made a child, a human being, subtle and refined and cultured. And culture doesn't come by being able to set up a beautiful dining table or by being able to wear the most beautiful classy outfits. It's a culture of your own inner being. If that culture has come in us, then we can say we are educated, we are not only literate. Now, educationists world over have been grappling with the problem of value education. UNESCO in 1900s was talking about value education. Harvard is talking about value education. Stanford is talking about value education. And yet the whole world is grappling with the problem of how education can actually become value-oriented education. You know where the problem lies? The problem lies that we are trying to reinvent a wheel which has been which has already been invented. Do we need to reinvent fire? How to make fire? Do we need to reinvent how to make the wheel? Why are we trying to reinvent that something has been done ages back by our sages? What you heard from our students here, they were speaking Sanskrit mantras. Now those Sanskrit mantras are giving us exactly what is to be done with elders, what is to be done with your own being, what is your connectivity with the world, what is your connectivity with the divine, where is the divine? The divine is inside my soul. How do I connect with the soul? All that we need to learn to become a good human being has already been written by our sages in Sanskrit. So we don't need to tell them the 10 things not to do. Do not steal, do not do this. It doesn't help. It never helps to tell a child, do not do that. Because the minute you say do not, that's the first thing that comes to the mind and stays in the mind. We need to tell them what to do and how to do. And that's why in Seth M.R. Jaipuria School, Lucknow, since 2003, we created our own curriculum, a Sanskrit, conversational Sanskrit curriculum called Deva Bhasha. And our children in Seth M.R. Jaipuria School, as well as NAVSRIJAN, because NAVSRIJAN and Seth M.R. Jaipuria have exactly the same curriculum, whether it is English, Hindi, Maths, Social Studies, Science, Dance, Singing, Music, Art, everything that Seth M.R. Jaipuria School students do, these NAVSRIJAN students do. So, coming back to Sanskrit, our Deva Bhasha curriculum is a curriculum teaching the children conversational Sanskrit. What's the difference between the Sanskrit that we learned in our times and conversational Sanskrit? The difference is that in conversational Sanskrit is taught, or rather not taught, imbibed. The way a child who's born in our homes speaks Hindi. Do we teach him Hindi? Do we teach him Hindi? We don't need to teach him Hindi. He learns it. He's soaked in Hindi. If he has a Bengali maid, he'll be soaked in Bengali as well. If he has a Punjabi father, he'll be speaking Punjabi as well. So, our Sanskrit curriculum soaks the child in Sanskrit from LKG. The child is really young. He wants to learn and soak up whatever is given to him. So the values are imbibed through those Sanskrit mantras very spontaneously. There's nothing do not do or do. It all just happens by the learning of those mantras. And that is the way of Jaipuria, Seth M.R. Jaipuria School, Lucknow, for teaching values. We do not teach, we just teach them Sanskrit. They speak in Sanskrit. You'd be amazed to know that there are around 50 children, 50, 60, just started with 20. And now there are around 50, 60 children in Jaipuria School who have chosen to study the Gita. Because of their love for Sanskrit, they want to know what does the Gita tell me. And continuously there are questions coming from them to me. Ma'am, answer these questions, answer, because Gita is not that easy to really understand. So once in a while, when I come over, they'll just come around and they'll have their questions, a rapid fire, and we'll do the answers. It is so fulfilling. The journey is beautiful. And what the children are getting is what all parents are looking for. And you'd be amazed also to know that there are so many parents of other religions. And I have them on record, on video. They have validated teaching Sanskrit because they say, because of Sanskrit, mere bacche ke values mein izafa aaya hai. Aap hamare Deva Bhasha Sanskrit curriculum ka jo website hai, Deva Bhasha ke website pe jaiye, you'll hear these parents speak about it. They'd make no bones about it. Another difference between literacy and education is educating the heart. And for that, very important part of education is dance, music, singing, sculpture, poetry. because these are the things that refine the senses. Every school does that. It's just how much importance do we give to it. In Sethe Mar Jaipuria school and Navsrijan, dance is mandatory from LKG to class 6 for every boy and every girl. They have to learn dance. In the beginning, when we started teaching dance to the boys, we were not sure how the parents would take it. And I was again amazed to see the response, because so many parents came and said, thank you for teaching my boy Bharatanatyam or teaching my boy Kathak, because we've got the curriculum made in such a manner. Also in Jaipuria school, as in Navsrijan, we have many different projects. I won't tell you about all the projects because I don't want to take away the stage from my beautiful children. But for instance, class 8 children, that's a project where they get 3-4 months in the beginning of the year to discover within their being what they would like to transform. The mission of Jaipuria school is conscious transformation. So they try to find out whether it's in their emotional being or in their mental being or in their physical being, what is it, that one thing that they want to consciously transform. Then they get 4 months or 5 months to work on it consciously, and they have to come up with a PowerPoint presentation starting from the reason why they chose that, what they did for 4 months. And then there's a jury of a parent, a peer and a teacher who marks them. So many children came up that they had a problem of a relationship problem with one of their parents. And since it's conscious transformation of my own being, so you cannot try to change your mother or you cannot try to change your father. So many children have repaired their relationships with their parents, or some have worked upon their jealousy, or some have worked upon their concentration, or some have worked upon their skill, some physical skill. So conscious transformation. So I won't talk much about it, but we have some 6-7 projects in the school, and they've been recognized for University of John Hopkins has done a brief thing on us, and all the 5 projects that we do have been covered by the University of John Hopkins. And then we do something called Healing Habitat. I won't talk about it. You can go to the website if you're interested. So University of Berkeley has picked up on our Healing Habitat and given us some 6-7 pages, the Greater Good Science Center. So all these things are the way we are imparting value education to our students. And that's the difference between literacy and education.
I would like to thank Anjali ma'am today for her concept, her vision, giving birth to Navsrijan and working tirelessly for it. And all these children, their parents and our society is grateful to Anjali ma'am for opening her heart out to these children. Jaipuria school has a huge infrastructure, but only 7% of it is used by these underserved children, with thousands of children waiting outside the gate to be admitted in Navsrijan and realize their dreams. But as you all know, all dreams need resources to be actualized. Your presence shows here that you too share our vision. The sponsorship per child is only 13,000 rupees. I would request you to please open your heart and join Navsrijan family. Thank you.
What is this, Sonal?
A globe.
A globe? But where is its green color gone?
This is our future Earth.
What do you mean?
It's very simple. The way we are cutting down the trees and polluting the environment, soon our Earth will become like this.
Oh, it's dreadful.
Yes, it is, but this is the fact. Okay, let me show you how we treat the trees.
Oh.
आंसू की तुझ में रवानी बहना रहा तो रहेगा न पानी मुझसे है सांसों की तुझ में रवानी बहना रहा तो रहेगा न पानी काटो मुझे दुखता है ना काटो मुझे बड़ा दुखता है
saving trees. I would just like to say that FLO also really believes in it, and we don't believe in giving out mementos or other flower bouquets and etc. So we give out a green certificate, that is that we plant a tree in your name. So I would just like to request Archana Aunty Ji to come and give this out. The first certificate is for the school, for the lovely children who've put up this show. Next, I would like to invite Asha Chattaji, the director of NAVSRIJAN, for a dedicated hard work for the upliftment of these children. Mrs. Anjali Jaipuria, who is the soul behind this program.
How NAVSRIJAN has changed my life. My life has changed after I got admission in NAVSRIJAN. How? Well, for that, I need to narrate an incident of my life. Earlier, whenever I visited the park near my house, nobody used to play with me, nor did anyone make me their friend, because I didn't understand English. But now things have changed. I can speak English better than them, make friends easily, and play with everyone in the park. I am the park team leader. Also, our teacher have inculcated good value in us through Sanskrit and value education. Whenever I come across the children who ignored me once, I play with them, talk to them, and also teach them new words I learn in English in school. I'm also fulfilling my father's dreams as he's a clerk. He never imagined his son can obtain quality education which NAVSRIJAN is providing me. Thank you. Thank you, Anjali ma'am.
Now welcome our tiny tots to enact our poem, Thrill Little Kittens.
Lost their mansion, and then they began.
means beyond the boundaries of darkness, looking at the highest blissful, absolute spiritual light. We belong to God of gods who lights the whole world, the sun god. The sun is the symbol of determination.
Dance has been an expression of emotions from centuries to come. It is a unique form of movement therapy which heals and frees us from physical, mental, emotional and spiritual blockages. Through dance, we express wonder, joy and happiness, community feelings, a sense of identity and freedom. Various emotions like love, empathy, hatred, rage and jealousy. So let's captivate and get enchanted by a dance performance by NAVSRIJAN students.
व्याकुल व्यासुल राधे का मन है, राधे के मन में वो मोहन है, जिस मोहन का श्यामल तन है, मदिरा सागर नयन नयन है, गिरधारी बन कुंज पे रैया, किसन कन्हैया बंस बजैया, गोकुल के वो है मुरलीधर, राधा झूमे झुमकी लय पर, कहती घूमे गिरधर गिरधर, राधा के गिरधर आए,
देखो राधा
आए, हाँ गिरधर आए,
राधा देखो
मुरलीधर गिरधर आए,
देखो राधा।
मैं राधा तेरी मेरा श्याम तू, पर यूं ना कहलाई थाम तू। मैं राधा तेरी मेरा श्याम तू, पर यूं ना कहलाई थाम तू।
Several arts. I also tried to enact a few dancers, but I always failed in giving expression, and nor was I able to follow the basic steps. A change took place in my life when I joined NAVSRIJAN. I started participating in dance programs. I was exposed to several dance forms, and I also understood the basic of dance. When I come to school, after helping my mother as a domestic helper in various houses. Dance gives me a lot of happiness and confidence. Thank you.
Bhadram karne bishrulu ya madeva bhadram pashe maksha kriya jatra sthirai rangai stashtu vagum sastanu vi vyashay madhe vaitayadayu swastina indro vratta shrava swastina pusha vishva veda swastina
Good evening, everybody. It's my pleasure to say thank you. A smile on a child's face is a delightful sight that touches the heart. And I believe everybody present here will say, yes, it's true. And Anjali ji has proved it, that we can make a child smile with just giving them a healing touch. Thank you, Anjali ji. Whatever you are doing, I think God will always bless you for this kind deed. On behalf of FICCI FLO, Lucknow Kanpur chapter, I thank you, Anjali ji, for such a wonderful program of NAVSRIJAN. Education is the only solution to poverty, as your banner also says. I agree with you, and the way you are doing it is superb. Thank you, Asha ji and teachers, for your efforts behind this show. And I think everybody will be agreeing with me that the choreographers, our teachers team, has really worked very hard to put up this show. Thanks to my dear children for such an amazing performance. Mera bhi dil kiya inke saath dance karne ko. Itna sundar dance dekhkar ekdam dil khush ho gaya. I wish to thank our FLO Lucknow Kanpur members for sponsoring food and gift hampers to these children. Aarti, our event chair, thank you very much, dear. And Shubhra Shruti, your team is amazing. Media is always supporting us. Thank you very much, media personals. Thank you. Thank you.